You already know.
You're listening to South City Radio.
In your face, in your eardrums, you heard?
98.5.
Powered by music.
Okay, guys, I am particularly very excited about this interview because every time I speak to this particular gentleman, he always showers me with words of praises in his own way. And it's actually quite funny because I never understand what he's saying. But I guess that's what actually makes it really dope. Hi, Slim Case. It's really nice to have you here.
Uh-huh.
How are you?
Rubilashi, draw the back up balance or tether lot of good effect. Go, Giro, be on someone who bobby on someone else. Or I saw one looting me to my lamba. Moeta baby, Joashinata, as a man.
Oh, shit. All I heard was my name, to be honest. And Azaman. So Mr. Azaman is truly in the studio today. Uh-huh. You know, it's really, really awesome what I will say, you know, you particularly have done with your sound. What would you call your sound? What would you refer to it as?
It's called the Ruby Music Sound.
The Ruby Music
I
Sound.
The Ruby, that's the alcoholic talking.
The alcohol.
The alcoholic talking.
Alcoholic talking.
It's like the drunken master in Slim Case.
Okay. It's interesting that you say that because I think I saw an interview where they were saying about, talking about how most people have this preconception that you drink a lot, you smoke a lot, you know.
You do.
Certain things a lot, you know. And funny enough, what you responded to was that you actually don't do any of those things. So is that actually true?
That's very true. 100%.
So you don't drink alcohol?
I don't take alcohol. I don't smoke. I'm only a very good actor.
Wow. Who would have ever thought or even thunk it, if that's a word?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's talk about, you know, your music and, you know, what you've done, the sound that you have indeed created. You know, there's so many people that also are, in a sense, I wouldn't say making the same music, but really flow very well with your music.
Yeah.
You know, the likes of Zlatan, Naira Marley, you know, them lot. Why do you think Nigerians are very, very into this particular sound that, you know, you are actually making?
I just believe that once you put out a successful sound out there, you have people that wanna be like that successful person. How am I gonna put it? I wanna sound like that. But I still believe that it's still different vibe because the message is different.
Okay.
I only talk about alcohol, the influence of alcohol. It's like you're trying to mix Jackie Chan with Jet Li. There's a different thing.
Mm.
Jet Li has to do with monks. Mm. Jackie Chan has to do with...
So, which one are you? Jackie Chan?
The Jackie style.
Okay. While the other ones are doing
street monks, Jet Li.
Okay. All right. Making lots of sense. Making lots of sense.
Yeah.
Now, you know, as I said, as you also said, you have spoken quite a bit about alcohol in your music. And, you know, a couple of artists have been speaking about internet fraud.
Okay.
I'm sure you must have heard.
I saw.
You know, what apparently has transpired. Some people have been arrested. What are your thoughts on that? And do you think that as musicians, we need to do, or you guys need to do more and actually be very, very particular about what you talk about in your music?
Yeah, you know, what I can say is that just because Genevieve Naji acted a prostitute doesn't make Genevieve Naji a prostitute. It's just we are just a very good actor.
Mm.
It now depends on what we want to act about.
Okay.
You understand? Sometimes some people might add, this one. He's an artist. Artist is acting. So we can't say this is what he do. Or if I'm talking, okay, look at me, Slim Case, I do rap or sing about alcohol, but I don't do it. I'm only a very good actor, like Kanayo do about the money ritual thing, but he's a Christian. So we're just an actor. We're a very good actor. But I believe is that anything we do, let's just try and still portray a good manners.
True.
Because of what those that are listening, you know, so we can won't influence them.
Yeah. Okay. So you know, let's talk about, you know, your collaborations so far. You have that amazing song Azaman with Tubaba, Larry Gaga.
Yeah.
Peruzzi, and I think there's someone else as well.
Neptune, DJ Neptune.
Yes, DJ Neptune. Greatness. Yeah. So you've got all those really, really superbly talented people on one song. Why, in a sense, do you think you seem to work well with artists featured or you being featured on an artist song? Like, why do you need the crowd? Do you personally think you can actually put out a single on your own?
Yeah.
No features, you know?
And well, I have two singles out there. My own single,
yes.
The Otumba Lamba, very successful. The Kalamo, very successful. Mm-hmm. But I have a message. My own calling is that I should introduce the posh to the street and the street to the posh, of which I can say I'll be one of the artists that started it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
After Smooth Doctor,
yes.
Started the Sesame Posh.
Very
you
true.
You understand, I brought, you know, Blackness of Tivo Savage, Whiskey, and I'm always still very happy to today that I work with Whiskey because I'm like the first street artist he ever featured in his career.
Nice.
So that's like my own Grammy.
Yeah, that's what you said.
So it's my calling. I can't work alone. Mm-hmm. I don't want to work alone. I want to work with more international celebrities because that's my calling. Mm-hmm. There's a mixture. I'm like the DJ Khalid, the industry hype man.
I love it.
Hype the push and introduce them to the street.
Okay, cool. So, you know, now you're even speaking about hyping.
Yeah.
And that's also something that you do.
I do hype you
very
too.
Exactly. And you do very, very well.
Yeah.
Do you think that there is indeed like a good industry for hype men now, right about now?
We don't have it right now. Like, there's no the best hype men, but they can choose like the best single, like the best featured song. But that's why I don't want to just be a hype man. I want to be a hype man with music, with song, so I can be nominated and it can pave more way for me.
Okay, shout out to you. I saw you at the MVPs last year, and you know there was even a lot of talk about, I think it was an interview that you did where you were speaking about, you know, in the hopes of having international collaborations with Cardi B. And so people were really trolling you. Why were people trolling you? Why do you think people were trolling you? Do you think people don't have faith in the sound?
Yeah, I believe people don't have faith in the sound. They believe it's too big for me. Just like last 3 years when I told my friends, one day Wizkid is going to feature me. They laughed at me. They're like, Wizkid of all people, we come and feature you this street artist. Oh. So I'm not using that same faith that the day will come. And it's this year to be Cardi, Offset, Slim Case, Travis Scott.
Amen. Oh, amen. Please, I hope it's me that will actually like premiere that song.
Yeah, that will meet
it has to be me.
This is a Meganja concert.
Arena. I'll host it. God, I feel so good.
Nigel, it's funny. Isn't it funny? What's going to happen though?
Yeah. At least we are witnesses in the studio. So good.
Let's record it very well. It's going to happen.
Okay, so now that you've put out, you know, all these various singles, especially, you know, as you said, works the likes of Wizkid, Tiwa Savage, DJ Any Money, like the list is endless. Like you're killing it. Like you're really, really killing it. You know, how are you going to put all of this together? Is there going to be like some sort of body of work?
An EP.
Okay. Do we have a name for that yet?
Yeah, the Forbidden Fruit.
Ooh.
The Knowledge of Good and Evil.
I'm really talking to the Bible, yo. Wow. Okay, where it all began. Genesis.
No, but that's just music, though. There's something good to learn from music. There's something bad to learn from music. Mm. So it's like knowledge of good and evil. It's like the Forbidden Fruit.
Good.
Even devil is a musician.
Yeah, true. He was in the choir. He was the head of the choir.
Yeah, he's still the head of the choir. No, different song.
No, different song. Okay, so we're hoping for the EP.
Yeah.
Anyone else would you love to work with? Because obviously now you've done the Wizkid collaboration. Right. Anyone else in Nigeria? Now you've done Two Baba. Like, you've worked with legends already. So I'm like, yeah, like what's next is definitely Cardi B, to be honest.
Oh, man, your point. You just saw the vision.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, with everything so far, are there any regrets? Is there anything that you regret? You know, any move that you made? Maybe not necessarily now, maybe in the past, or anything that you just feel, maybe I shouldn't have done that because maybe I would have been somewhere else if I did do it. Do you know what I mean? Any regrets?
And the only regret is that I only have one. That one is just, I should have been listening to Sound City for like 2 years now.
Okay. And why do you regret that?
because, you know, this is just the eye of entertainment. So I was looking at the ear instead of the eye.
I like the fact you have accepted this.
Apart from that, there's no regret. Everything has worked together for good.
Okay.
For them that love God. For them who are called according to a purpose.
Okay. So is there an Aza woman in Slim Case's life?
I think Aza collector. Yeah, I'm
saying. Oh, one? Yeah. Okay.
Moeta Bebe.
Oh, gosh.
My crush. I look at the name Abebe.
It's interesting.
It's not a baby.
It's interesting that you say that I'm the Aza woman, but I'm not seeing any of this Aza shine.
No, you're so my Aza. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my Aza.
Okay.
So, my listener, Moet is very beautiful. You need to see her in person.
Please try.
She's cute, romantic, beautiful,
romantic,
sexy. Elliot, shout out to Elliot.
What, Elliot?
I envy you.
Wow, you killed me.
Oh, wow, I don't know if you do, man.
My next video, you drop out. Okay, so as you said, the EP there apparently is a mysterious Aza woman that you are claiming is me that I'm not aware of.
I'm looking at my Aza woman. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and you know, obviously as you said, no regrets.
Yeah, no regrets.
So thank you so much, Slim Case, actually, for coming on the show. It's been long coming. Your energy is fire.
Thank you,
ma'am. My last question, actually, for you: do you think has there been anyone that has come to you to say you should change your sound, that your sound will not be accepted?
Well, my sound is whack.
Has there been anyone?
30%. 30% of Nigerians.
Mm.
Yeah, they're like...
So what do you have to say to those, to that 30%?
I don't have anything to say. Let me just keep doing what I love doing. They will still come back. Okay. In fact, 10 came back last month. Yeah, another 10% came back. I'm like, man, as a man on fire. We thought it's over. We thought this was some kind of thing, but you still have more. Keep it up. So we just keep doing it.
Keep pushing.
Yeah, so we shut the O2 arena down.
All right. Amen. Smart. And Moya Bebe is going to be the host, by the way.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much. Any last words to your fans and our listeners out there?
Yeah, to all my listeners, thank you very much. Thank you for the As a Man movement. Thank God for everything He has done for me. And to all my fans, keep believing in yourself. Anything you know how to do, do it, man, and be positive about it. Have confidence. Anything is possible. Like, I'm dreaming that one day, I'm a Moeta Bebe. I'm an honeymoon.
Oh, my God.
I mean, in Miami, anything is possible. You need to see Moeta Bebe in person. She's very, very sweet. That's the only father. So, come on, up the line. Thank you. One love.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You're fired.
Fire it up, that is.
We on fire.
We are Sound City 98.5.